are going to be building a Da Vinci bridge. So we're not gonna use any tape or anything to put these pencils together. They will be just holding on to each other. And the goal is to see how strong this bridge can be.
Push this one further back. You see how like it's not really gonna like cover. Ooh.
Let's try again. Start it again. Humans are natural born engineers. They have been solving problems by building things for thousands of years.
We're doing great, everybody.
This one.
Whether you use concrete and iron or cardboard and duct tape, it all counts as engineering.
Ta-da! And you can lead your kids through activities and encourage them to solve problems using the engineering design process.
Ha ha ha! I'm Javier, and I'm a STEM educator.
And I'm Daisy, the host of Design Squad.
Design Squad is made so that anyone, regardless of their experience with engineering, can lead engineering activities.
Here is what you need to know so you can feel confident in leading your kids through the engineering design process.
Engineering is for everyone. You do not need an engineering or science background to lead successful engineering activities. In fact, you have probably been engaging in engineering and invention your whole life without even realizing it. Have you ever designed something to solve a problem? Maybe you've created a new system for organizing your desk, or even found a way to get all the toothpaste out of the tube. This is engineering and invention.
You're not alone. You might feel like you're leading engineering activities solo, but you have engineering allies. Is there someone in your program, family, or community you can turn to, perhaps using your own funds of knowledge?
View unknown answers as opportunities. It is likely that your kids will ask questions that you don't have the answers to. This is a great opportunity to model for your group how to investigate and find answers. Although it might be uncomfortable at first, co-learning can be a rewarding experience for both you and your kids.
Practice doesn't make perfect, but it does make you prepared. The engineering and design process can be ambiguous without a straightforward path from problem solving to solution. It's a great idea to try out some activities before you run them in your program. Even though it won't allow you to know exactly how the session will go, it will give you an idea of what your kids will experience, including possible challenges or sticking points they might face.
Embrace iteration. An iterative process is not only a key part of engineering, but is also a key part of teaching engineering. Just as your kids will experience failure and redesign during engineering activities, so will you as you lead your group. Maybe you end up over-directing one day, or maybe you accidentally give away the answers. It's okay. Experiencing failure and missteps is an important part of an engineering process, and those mistakes always offer valuable knowledge. Learning from those failures is what makes engineers better and better. So try to embrace failure as much as possible during engineering activities and while leading your group.
Whether you are new to engineering or you have lots of experience, you have all the skills you need to lead engineering activities.
For more engineering activities and resources, check out the Design Squad Latinx collection here.